Now, the approach adopted in understanding all the psychological processes tries to make the experience, action, behavior. No, you take all these and you translate it into something which can be measured, which can be assessed, which can be examined. If you look at the whole effort, it tries to adopt a kind of a third person perspective. So, some tool is given to you, let us say, a tool to measure personality, and you respond on that. The tool provides certain kinds of reports from you, and that report is quantified using some kind of numerical system that we call psychological assessment, and on that basis we get certain scores, and we then tell that your personality is like this. It's extroverted, introverted, or it has high neuroticism, and so on. So this is the strategy that has been adopted. If you go into the details, you find that it has many problems. The problems were not taken care of because it was thought that we are getting numbers, we are adopting a scientific method, and we are getting something real, objective, fact. This perspective has continued and is still continuing to a large extent. At the same time, there have been certain biases which doubted the whole effort and exercise, and different kinds of analyses were put. I'm sure you must have heard the name of Freud and Jung and many others who looked at unconscious processes. Processes which are not easily accessible, but which can be understood in terms of certain mechanisms that are postulated at a theoretical level, and they can be accessed indirectly. Now, all that has led to development of depth psychological perspectives. So, in addition to objective observable reality, the approach provided a way to understand something which is beyond the domain of conscious behavior. And the struggle has been going on. The main emphasis for majority of psychologists has been to create a construct, then create some kind of operational definition of that. That is, the construct is made accessible in terms of certain operations, certain activities. And using that, you apply some kind of scaling or rating. And then you come up with some kind of empirically derived assessment which is quantitative. And I think that has provided a way to understand one kind of reality. But definitely this reality is not a real reality in the sense that it has been reported, it has been analyzed in some way, it is mediated by some kind of instrumentation, And it is helpful in some way that you are able to relate in quantitative ways. You apply various statistical techniques to make certain generalizations, and that helps to some extent to understand.